Battle Cats has joined the game. And they rolled a 4 to my 2.
Sick, I know. My opponents have been mulliganing a lot today, but I've been mulliganing a lot too. That's just what happens in Modern. Scry to the bottom. If my opponent had scryed to the top, I would have cared a bit more about when I cast this Gataxian Probe, but I think, in general, it's just better to see what's in their hand now. Farseek and Primeval Titan. Okay. I'm taking on a little bit of risk here, because if my opponent was to draw exactly Lightning Bolt, I would lose, where otherwise I might win against that card. But given that I just saw his hand, and time is a serious factor in deciding if I win or lose this game. I'm just going to leave up my pump no matter what, or my protection card no matter what. I'll probe next turn, and it'll be much more reasonable for me to decide how the game ends. Because I already know what's in his hand, and I already know there's nothing he can do to stop me, but he could draw a card that I'm not even aware of, and then the next turn when I probe him, I'll be able to beat that card. Farseek, sure. Sacred Foundry, what in the world? I have no idea what that could be for. Bring to Light, maybe? Mountain and Primeval Titan. I will show no more cards. Okay, we got a weird Scapeshift deck. I think Dismember. These decks do usually have Chalice of the Void. I'll bring in Unravel the Aether, but I won't bring in Nature's Claim. I think they usually do have Spellskite as well. Apostle's Blessing seems kind of bad. I think I like Spell Pierce much more than Dispel. It can counter, like, Farseek at least. One card heavy. Should it just be Twisted Image? So one, two. That way I have four answers to Spellskite. That does seem reasonable to me. Yeah, Distortion Strike's kind of bad. I could see it coming up with, like, getting my Glistener off through, like, Courser of Grufix, but I'd rather just build for the cards that beat me rather than the cards that could beat me. Clear Mulligan for me. Clear Keep. Oh, that's a top. That is going to result in a turn 3 win. Let's probe to see what's up. Anger of the Gods and Chalice of the Void. Okay, well, we correctly identified our opponent had Chalice, which is cool, but is not going to matter much. Anger, Chalice, Oath, Search. Chalice, Oath, Search. Red and Valakut. Okay, what do I need to draw here? Spell Pierce would be cool. Might as well just probe again. Not getting any better. So, I could go Inkmouth Nexus. He goes Chalice for one. I go Attack for one. He goes Stuff. I go Attack for one. So if I just Attack for one every turn and then become immense, I have a win on turn. So turn two, I hit for one. Turn three, I hit for one. Turn 4, I hit for 9, 7, puts him to 9. Then turn 5, I win. His hand looks like it's going to go chalice. Is he really going to chalice one with Oath of Nissa in his hand? That's interesting. I guess I might as well play it. I guess my logic here is that I don't want to just play a Blighted Agent if it's going to get Anger of the Gods anyways. Normally I would do that because I could draw another Blighted Agent. But if I draw another Blighted Agent, it might just be slower than using Inkmoth Nexus every turn. And from my perspective, if there's any chance that my opponent would not Chalice 1 to lock out his own Oath of Nissa, then it's good because if he just goes like Oath of Nissa Valakut, tapped, which is a reasonable line of play that my opponent could do, then when I play Blighted Agent, on the next turn he goes Anger the Gods. On the next turn there's not a Chalice 1 in play. I can go activate Nexus, Might of Old Krosa. I get to win a turn faster. At least that was my line of thinking for what I did there. I think given that my opponent has Anger the Gods in hand, this is the right play. I could just beat him with an Inkmoth Nexus. Like, he has Oath, Anger the Gods, Valakut, random card. Wow, that is a really good draw. I did not account for the fact that I could draw that card. I think that's just going to result in a win next turn. Search for tomorrow. This actually worked out really well because I just completely ignored the fact that he had Anger the Gods in his hand, and I used my mana efficiently, and I'm going to win on turn four. Pretty cool. Pretty cool stuff. Bang. All right, completed the league.